Guys.
Mama Sherry's Soul Food Shack has hit rock bottom.
We have put so much of our own money in it and on it, we no longer have it.
The customers just aren't biting.
1:10 Saturday lunchtime, and this place should be absolutely rammed.
There's too many cooks doing all the wrong things.
Oh, fucking hell.
If you turned up for work half an hour late in my kitchen, you'd be home for the day, looking for a new fucking job.
Turn this into a professional outfit within a week, that would take a miracle.
I've definitely got it.
It's time to get serious.
And if you don't break away from this stuff, I swear to God the business is going to close.
You need, young man, a fucking rocket up your ass.
I'm not going to lose my business.
Brighton, London by the sea. Loads of locals and a steady stream of hungry tourists. Nesting just a stone's throw away from the seafront is Mama Sherry's Soul Food Shack, offering classics from America's deep south.
Oh, nice, nice, nice.
The big soul mama, aka Sherita Jones, has raised 33 foster children, but running her first restaurant is proving a far bigger handful.
It's all gonna just kind of go and fall apart. So I don't want it to fall apart.
God, it's definitely a shack on the outside anyway. Fucked up caravan. Is this it?
Sherita.
Sherita, Gordon,
yes.
Good
Hello,
to see
Gordon.
You.
Nice to see you.
This
Welcome.
Is small and quaint.
Welcome. It's quaint, it's cozy.
I'll say. It's
not
like
so
walking,
small.
It's like walking into your
my
front lounge.
Thank you. And see? That's what it's supposed to be about. Because I tend to spend all my life here, this has got to be my front room. Otherwise, when do I get to kick my feet up?
So after 3.5 years, despite throwing everything at this place and working 7 days a week, Sherita is still in serious debt to the tune of £65,000.
And who's the chef?
I'm kind of the chef. I come from a background of big mamas, and all of them cook. Mm-hmm. It's called stick to your ribs, basically.
Stick to your roots?
Ribs!
Oh, ribs, right.
Stick to your roots, to your ribs.
Mama Sherry's shack seats 40 at an extremely intimate squeeze.
But yes. I am not a West Indian restaurant.
But sadly for Sherita, that's not often a problem, as weekday trade is virtually non-existent.
It's great at the weekends, mm-hmm. but somehow we've discovered that we're in a hole. We're just in this hole, a financial hole, that we can't claw our way out of. Mm-hmm.
Have you made any money since you've been open?
Nope, not a penny. Not a single penny have we made since we've been open. It's hard to put our finger on why.
Is it critical? I mean,
yes.
how long can you continue staying like this? Truthfully,
I'd say 3 to 6 months.
Maximum.
So
no customers, no money.
Mind your head.
Right.
It's time to check out the kitchen.
God.
Sherita calls herself the cook, but Brian Moyo is her head chef. So who's in charge?
How you doing, dude?
Fine, thank you.
Do you do this and all that and Paul and...
I try not
yeah.
to.
Wait, you don't go in for cliches.
No. So are you the head chef or are you the cook? Why? I'm confused.
Well, I was employed to come as a head chef.
Right.
But because of problems with finances uh-huh. and things like that... So
don't let me stop you.
I took a sit back.
So who writes the menu?
Sherita has written everything. She does uh-huh. everything, basically.
So you've got a cushy job then, really, haven't you?
You could say that. Uh-huh. As a chef, yes.
Pretty chill.
Huh? Yeah, as a chef, yes, it's pretty chill. But
a head chef who doesn't write the menu and only works 35 hours a week. Next, he'll be telling me he's forgotten how to cook.
Here you go. We've got some catfish goujons with uh-huh. hush puppy and our homemade pineapple salsa.
Yours,
ladies.
Yes. Mm.
This one, Lars. It's actually quite nice. Very delicate fish. And it's nicely fried. It's very light. Really nice.
Thank you. Be back with your mains. Take it down pretty for my mama and mother to make it.
God. For mains, my plate's piled high with a clumsy mess of ribs, spicy chicken jambalaya, and corn and bean succotash.
I hope he likes it.
Mmm. Fucking hell. Those ribs. So tender. I have to say, it's thrown on the plate with no real care, but it tastes phenomenal. This may be the first time I actually go back to the kitchen with an empty plate.
Thank you. Bloody delicious.
Thank you.
And you know what?
Thank you.
I thought it was going to be really spicy, but it's toned down, and it was spot on.
Thank
you. It actually made me feel like I was back at Mum's for the first time.
Oh.
And having some home cooking. It was very good.
Oh, don't get me crying.
There are things I would change.
Okay, fine.
And tweak,
and I'm happy.
Definitely.
I'm happy to
but
hear about
in general,
that. I gotta take a picture of this plate. I know it sounds crazy. I know it sounds crazy.
Mama,
mind your head, mind your head.
Oh God.
I fed Gordon Ramsay. And he cleaned his plate.
How the hell did you turn that thing off? She doesn't shut up. Rabbit, 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 rabbit. Shit.
Sherita's down-home style should be a unique selling point, but it ain't working. I need to go back to the kitchen and find out why. Friday, and Sherita's tackling most of the day's preparation single-handedly in a desperate bid to save money.
Part of this is, you know, you've got to get your hands dirty.
Yeah, of course, sir.
Marinating meat, making dressings, sauces and bacon are all crucial things to prepare in advance of a busy service.
And it's just shaking off the excess. Yep.
But deep frying chicken wings 8 hours in advance of their first booking, that can't be right.
Yep. So why'd you cook them now?
Because if you cook them off now and leave them to cool, when the order comes in, it's just a matter of picking out how many we need and they go back in and they come back up to a nice...
And they don't go dry?
No.
I'm beginning to suspect the good old home cooking isn't as wholesome as it could be.
They smell good.
Most of it's coming from the freezer rather than the sole.
So how many freezers have we got?
13.
Fuck me.
By the time Brian turns up, there's not much left for him to do.
So I mean, you can't really feel like a head chef if you've got Sherita in the kitchen every morning cooking the food and you come in
that's
and just
you
send
know.
It. In the sense that you're not actually really cooking, you're just coming in and putting things together.
Putting things together, yes. It's kind of hard, yes.
Have you lost motivation?
Yes.
So, if Sherita's head chef's gone off the boil, I'm hoping her remaining crew of part-timers have a bit more spunk. Heading up front of house is Lauren. She arrives 10 minutes late for the evening service. 20-year-old AD seems to be more committed to his glamorous day job.
So why panel beating?
I don't know. Finish at 4:30 every day.
Okay. Kitchen porter Gavin lives next door, but he appears to turn up when he feels like it. And Sherita's librarian husband, Phil, hotfoots it back from the day job to become basement barman and resident DJ.
He looks like your washer-upper.
No way!
I have been known to wash
it. He does that as well.
These and numerous other part-time staff are all members of Mama Sherry's big laid-back family.
So when he's in the ship, in the middle of service, slow them down like fucking Michael Jackson.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, fucking hell.
I hate to ruin a good party, but if you want to run a successful business, then the terms laid-back and professional just don't mix. It's not just about how good the food tastes, it's about how it fucking gets there as well. And that is crucial.
I can't wait to see this team of jokers in action.
All right, so we get going. They're hungry.
Immediately, it's clear who's the mummer in this kitchen.
I'm getting you a chili pepper because you ain't no. Just the one.
Can I take the seeds out at least?
Sherita talks to them like they're her children, and she's the only one cooking anything from fresh.
I need to start cooking up these fajitas now.
Okay, Sherita, all of the second party are in.
All right, okay. Two potato skins, onion rings, cornbread, 2 pieces. Can I get some jambalaya heated up, please?
For Brian and Adie, it's just an elaborate heating and plating up exercise. Mountains of messy food, school dinner style. A D minus, must try harder.
That's hot gravy.
Yep.
Yeah. On hot turkey.
Yep.
Served on cold plates.
Yep.
With cold salad.
Yep. It's first.
What's he laughing at? This is serious.
You weren't going to break sweat there, were you?
Okay. Oh, you were. Yeah. He's about to kick off.
When? There's twice as many staff as there need be. This should be an absolute breeze. But Sherita's killing herself, trying to do everything.
We've got everything in the basement, yeah? Everything's gone.
Paying two fully qualified chefs to dress and send a plate of nachos. Come on, that's a surefire way to break a business.
Fucking hell, it's painful. Okay. Very, very painful. Right. Tonight, on several occasions, you're standing here, cooking away in a world of your own.
Yeah.
And these guys standing there just almost playing with themselves because they're waiting for something from you. If you are the head chef,
yes,
then you're going to have to start taking the reins.
Yeah.
I want to try and get through a busy night without pissing your pants with laughter. 2 hours pure concentration without laughing.
OK.
And I bet you can't do it.
I can do it.
Are you fucking smiling already?
If there was ever a case of too many cooks, this is it. One of them will have to go.
The pan's cooked already. I said no smiling, no laughing. Okay. Serious.
OK.
Set a fucking example.
I'm going to.
And do not be scared to get rid of baggage.
Brighton's best-kept secret, Mama Sherry's Soul Food Shack, is so well-kept, it's losing £1,000 a week.
No one in. 20 past 10 in the morning. No.
By day three, I've uncovered a couple of reasons why.
I know it's chilled, but fucking hell, not as chilled as a snap. Why is no one here this time in the morning? It's ridiculous.
Firstly, the food's good, but it could be so much better.
Where's Brian? Let me give you a hand.
Brian?
Yeah.
I have no idea. It should be here soon.
Secondly, there are far too many staff, and most of them aren't pulling their weight.
Late this morning?
Yes,
about half an hour. What'd you do to him when he's late?
Nothing.
Nothing?
I'm just gonna wash up right now.
So you're washing up as well?
Yes.
She's in, she opens up, brings all the supplies upstairs. You should be ashamed of yourself. Brian.
Sherita's next task is to make a huge batch of macaroni cheese that will last her for 2 whole weeks.
Let me just keep this going. Oh, this is coming up nicely.
Hot from the stove, her food is irresistible. People will travel miles to taste it.
I like that.
Yeah?
Yeah, very nice.
But like a lot of her home cooking, this lot is destined for the freezer, where its delicious texture and flavour will be lost forever.
Well, you cook beautifully.
Yeah.
And I don't understand why you want to freeze it when it's so tasty.
I don't think it's not a case of wanting.
No, I think you've got into a habit.
I've gotten a habit.
Which is a lazy habit. Mm. You're not lazy because you work so bloody hard.
Yeah,
he's lazy.
It's a matter of...
He's definitely lazy. If you turned up for work half an hour late in my kitchen, trust me, you'd be home for the day.
No.
Looking for a new fucking job.
To be honest, it's no wonder Brian's lost heart. The man's been working in the kitchen for as long as I have. But to save money, he's been sidelined.
I was gone by 11:15.
So much so, he's rarely involved in actually making any of the food.
There is a kind of a method to my madness.
But you're throwing it together.
It looks like I'm throwing it together, but I throw it together the exact same way every single week.
So when you're not doing it, who does it?
I'm doing it.
That's my point.
Okay.
If Sherita was using Brian properly, they could ditch the freezers once and for all.
And the macaroni and cheese is nearly there.
That looks delicious. Yeah. I think that should go to staff food.
Yeah, I think so. Does look good, doesn't it?
As it stands, few customers will taste the food at its best. Sherita's thrown away her unique selling point. They call it Stormy Monday. And boy, does she need one. But Tuesday's just as
bad. It's 1:10, Saturday lunchtime, and this place should be absolutely rammed. And there's not a soul in here. Wednesday's worse, and
Thursday's also sad. This is dire. Saturday and Sunday are your prime days for business. But like many failing restaurants, Sherita's making some classic mistakes.
Poor man's meat pie.
Yeah.
£8.
Yeah.
I know it's going to be good.
Mm-hmm,
it is. You go onto the menu here, you've got main courses at 14.
Yeah.
£15.
Mm-hmm.
Why have they gone up so expensive?
To pay my bills. Mm-hmm. To be blunt, it was bank manager. accounting, and I was saying, help me, how do I do this? They say, you gotta raise your prices.
Always the bank manager's solution.
Yeah.
Well, Put your prices up.
And it was literally down to the bank manager.
Yeah. Well, he's an arsehole.
Oh, good.
Yeah. It's killing the business. Mm. I want to look at restructuring the menu.
Okay.
Making it a little bit shorter.
Okay.
Tweaking the portion size.
All right.
Having less come back.
60% are bones come back. But it's that 40% I want to work on.
Mm-hmm.
The objective for every customer coming through that door is to have a starter, a mains, and a dessert.
Okay.
You wait and see the turnover treble if you can squeeze three courses out of them.
Okay.
But before we can squeeze anything out of anybody, we need customers. And if they're not coming to us, we've got to take Mama Sherry's finger-licking food to them.
So, got the meatloaf.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, got the ribs.
Yeah.
OK, got the chicken. That smells amazing.
Oh, it's smelling so good. So good.
And who better to flaunt it than the Mama herself?
Don't be shy. Whoa. I'm going to come to you since you're not coming to me. All cooked fresh at Mama Cherry's Soul Food Shack just around the corner there. Yeah. Pretty good. This particular food is called soul food, okay? Cooked from the soul, from the heart.
Boy, she's good. A soul food evangelist, and she's out to convert the whole of Brighton.
Soul food! Can I hear you all say it? Soul food! All right.
Just wind her up and let her go.
That's nice, isn't it?
That's lovely. Okay.
Give me some more wings. All right.
Don't forget, this time it's on the house. Next time they're paying you.
Yep.
Did you cook things?
Yes, I did.
There's no doubt that Sherita's a terrific cook, but she's employing Brian to do that job, and I'm beginning to realise she's wasted in the kitchen.
What's it called?
Soul food!
Thank you! Just call me Mama.
Thank you, Mama.
You got it.
With Saturday night service about to begin, it's time to get this shack in order.
It's pretty obvious that the business is in dire straits. You know, that's real.
It's real.
That's the truth. Watching you guys over the last couple of days, you actually treat it like it's your fucking home. Chilled, relaxed. And this lady here, you talk to her almost as if it's your mum.
Mm-hmm.
And that really has to stop if this is going to go any further. And if it doesn't work, not only are you out of business and your livelihood's gone, all of you guys are out of a fucking job.
Yeah.
You've got no work.
Yeah.
So when it's that far down, we really have to dig deep and come up with sensible ideas.
Yeah.
And tonight, I'm going to ask you to stay out the kitchen.
Okay.
You've got so much to sell.
Yeah.
And you're a fucking good cook.
Thank you.
So, Sherita, let him cook.
I'm going to let him. I'm going to let him. I am.
Good. You have to pass the reins over now. And if you don't break away from this stove, I swear to God, the business is going to close. And let them do the job that you fucking pay them money for.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yep. I'm going to go put some makeup on, because I'm going downstairs.
Sherita's street hustling has secured a fully booked restaurant tonight. If we're going to get through it, we need to get this kitchen working like an efficient, well-oiled machine.
Eddie, are you doing that now, yeah?
Fantastic. Time to whip up a bit of professionalism into these boys.
Gabby, can you take those starters and food downstairs? Yeah, just standing there and doing nothing.
Five for five.
There you go.
Five.
Thank you. Are we standing there?
Yeah.
Open up your eyes, and get in fucking working, okay? You're running this place tonight, you know that?
Yes.
You're going to prove to her downstairs that you can do it?
Yes.
Yeah? Not just to her, but to yourself and me.
Yeah.
I said no smiling, no laughing.
Okay.
Serious.
Okay.
Yes?
Yeah.
Let's go.
She's still smiling now.
Good evening. Have you had a chance to look at the menu?
Yeah.
Downstairs, Sherita slipped effortlessly into the role of the hostess with the mostest.
Any of you eat macaroni and cheese?
We do.
I'm telling you, it's fantastic.
Gordon grated my cheese.
Brian's taking his first decision as the head chef. Pre-cooked buffalo wings are off the menu. From now on, they're being cooked to order.
Yep. Chicken's been cooked from fresh. Nice. People are ready. This place has turned around in 20 minutes.
Well, almost. The rest of the food's going out just as Sherita's always done it. Hot food, cold plates, uninspiring salads.
Right, £4 for that? That's shocking.
And jaw-breaking meatloaf.
What time are we closed tonight? You're laughing.
But let's not try to run before we can walk.
Can I get this one as soon as possible?
Yep, it's going. It's going. It's going possible. In your oven. The cheese is
cooked. Mm-hmm.
How long? Give Sherita a time.
3 minutes.
Three minutes. Okay. There we are.
That's
right. I'll take that.
Take
that. Thank you, Sherita. Bye.
Okay.
See ya.
All right.
There you go. Up.
The restaurant's full. But now she's front of house. Sherita's using every trick in the book to boost business.
5 minutes.
So
you
slow.
Go right next door to my friendly pub.
There you go.
And I will
see you in five.
See you in five.
Thank
okay.
you. Thank you.
Okay.
Brian, move up.
2 hours in, and the food's not going out quick enough. Sherita's faith in Brian is dwindling fast.
These guys have been in a long time.
I got kids down there.
Yeah, but their starters have just gone.
They've
got starters.
Okay.
What happened now with those starters?
With those starters, they're done.
So already in the lift?
Yeah. There, Eddie, aren't they?
What?
These starters.
What ones?
For this table.
These ones, man, I'm burning them now.
Oh, shit, I just told her they're gone, man.
For Brian, 3 years of living in a culinary coma is a hard habit to break. He's beginning to lose it. And Sharita's constant interruptions aren't exactly helping.
Come on, Brian. Don't lose it now, yeah?
No.
What else on this table? I need to see. What's on it?
You got hot wings and barbecue chicken wings.
I've got the hot wings. I need whatever else is there. Because they are getting restless.
Oh, dear.
That all they order?
That's it. Send it away.
I am so sorry. I'll tell you what the problem was.
With fresh food, yeah, you can't expect the food to just jump on your plate just like that.
We can explain that to her after. Yeah. Yeah.
Chicken takes a good 14, 20 minutes to make sure that, you know, you don't kill anyone.
Okay, has that pig feet go on? Because it needs to go on now, because it takes the time, yeah? Mm-hmm.
Every minute you're in here, we're losing money.
Fucking hell.
So, what do you think of that meatloaf?
Bloody good.
Thank you. Didn't I tell you? Didn't I tell you?
I thought the kitchen got off to a really good start. You were slightly nervous being down there because you were sort of not spying on them, but coming up, agitated.
Yeah.
Yeah. You lost it, Brian?
A little bit, yes.
A little bit.
And things just got a little bit on top.
You said something interesting, though. Yeah. Sharita has to understand it's going to take 3 or 4 minutes longer because I'm cooking from raw. Yeah. And the benefit is the customer. But I think this guy, with the help of AD, can get faster.
Yeah.
Much faster. I mean, how would you sum up? You're in the dining room tonight.
It felt good because I'm telling you, for 3.5 years being here, it was the first Saturday night that I have spent downstairs.
They've seen you, you know, that's the face they want to see when they come to see Mama.
Downstairs, I'm going to be cracking the whip a lot harder.
It's your business, of course.
You know, and that's what I was thinking, you know, I got to crack it.
Let's go.
Okay.
Thank you.
Good. Okay. Thank you, guys. Let me go down here and finish seeing because I got a few more desserts to sell.
Yeah.
If Brian's going to win Sharita's respect as her head chef, he needs to become more involved in preparing the food as well as cooking it.
Number 13, lucky for some.
But since his hours were cut, he's been dropped in a catch-22 situation.
Where's little lady gone?
Hey! Brian's been left holding the baby.
It became a problem because Claire had to go to work.
Yeah.
And we had to find a way of meeting the bill at the end of the month.
Yeah.
You know, and that's why I can't do Tuesdays and Wednesdays. The whole thing is just confused.
Yeah.
You know.
As Brian's involvement with the food has diminished, so too has his confidence. The first time he made meatloaf 2 years ago, it was a disaster. So we're going to prove that Brian can not only do it, but do it better.
How much influence do you have on the menu?
Even sometimes I'll do a menu or something, but she changes it anyway, so really at the end of the day, my influence disappears.
But you've got to be strong now.
Yes.
If she's going to concentrate in the dining room,
yes.
You're going to be running the kitchen.
Yes.
You have to be strong.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
The problem with Sharita's meatloaf is the bacon. By the time it's cooked, it's like cutting into leather.
The back bacon you saw dries out. It's hardly any fat in back bacon.
There's
no
fat.
Okay, so, streaky bacon. Place one nice, fatty piece of bacon there. Mm-hmm. As it's cooking, it's putting moisture inside the meatloaf. Yeah?
Fantastic. You know, if I put my foot down and say, no, this is like this, like that, I think I can see myself going far, you know, I can achieve things. It's a happy feeling, you know. It's a happy feeling.
Wow. Just look at them.
The seasoning is just right. It's not too salty.
I think that's fine. Doesn't need anything else. Anything else at all. No.
With Brian's confidence slowly returning, now I've got to work on Sharita. She excels as a natural cook and a great hostess.
Oh my God, that's everything on my menu.
Sharita.
But when it comes to business, she's a self-confessed numbskull.
Yeah, 1.5 meters long.
And this tells me the money is, look out, that's a bit shorter.
Shorter, yeah. We want it the other way around.
I want it the other way around.
Definitely.
But it's not just the takings that are the problem here. Okay.
200 grams of butter.
Right.
Yeah?
Like a beautifully risen cake, successful restaurants only thrive when three key business factors are working in close harmony.
Gradually adding 200 grams of flour. We establish one-third staff costs, one-third food costs, and one-third gross profit. Combine all those ingredients into one recipe.
Yeah.
Chemistry. You have the most amazing cake. Mm-hmm. And that's how any good business works.
Yeah?
At the moment, Shrita's business cake is way off course.
Okay. I'm going to show you something, what we've got currently happening here at the shack.
With few midweek customers, Shrita's gross profits are dangerously low.
Very, very little profit.
Her food costs are reasonably healthy, but her massive overheads are crippling her.
Well, I just want to show you what it's going to cost you when we start adding really high staff costs. So there's an imbalance already.
God.
Yep. Bloody hard. Now, I'm doing this on purpose to prove a point.
Yeah.
You can't complete a recipe for a successful business when you've got an imbalanced situation.
You can tell me to fuck off, but how much do you pay yourself a month?
I pay a month? I get around 200 a week, that's it. I'm the lowest out of the kitchen.
£200 a week?
A week, yeah.
£800 a month?
A month, yeah.
You're working 7 days a week?
I'm working 7 days a week.
That's a fucking disgrace.
Even 80 gets more than me some weeks.
A commis chef that's part-time gets paid more than you. You're far too fucking soft.
I know.
You really are far too soft.
Well.
It stops now.
I know.
That is a profitable business with the right ingredients.
Uh-huh, yeah.
That is what you're currently running.
Right.
Have a think and let me know which one you'd like to eat.
Very good. Oh, I just feel like crying.
Why are you crying, Shrita?
Because I'm not going to lose my business.
I'm nearing the end of my week in Brighton.
Ah, fucking bollocks.
Not sure I've found my soul yet, but Brian is finally beginning to behave like a head chef. And Shrita is undergoing a transformation from mother to matron. And from now on, she'll be ruling this roost with an iron hand.
This is not a drop-in center.
But we still have a fundamental problem, a crippling lack of weekday customers. What we need is a gimmick, a bargain that will ensure the shack's full to the rafters all week long.
The idea is to sell your restaurant per table.
Okay.
Okay, so a table of six.
Uh-huh.
Six chairs.
Yep.
£10 a head.
Uh-huh.
£60 for that table. If that worked
every
night at £10 a head,
there's
£360 in the till. Think of it this way.
Yeah.
They'll spend the same amount of money
on their alcohol.
On alcohol.
My plan is to create an exciting three-course fixed buffet for each table, simplifying the service and cherry-picking from the existing menu.
Okay.
But before we do the big presentation to Shrita, I've got to inject some life into those god-awful limp salads.
How much does salad cost on the menu?
It's £4.50.
£4 fucking 50. Huh? Do you think that's real good value for money for what you're serving?
Not really.
No? Huh? Made a very simple dressing here. Roasted cumin.
Yes.
Yeah? A little bit of olive oil.
Uh-huh.
Fresh lime.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Look at the difference now. And start building it up. And get some colours in there. Yeah? £4.50 for a salad. It's a fucking joke.
Sweet potatoes. Huge in soul food, yeah?
Yes.
All they've done is been blanched.
Yes.
Into the pan.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Nicely coloured. Don't move them until they've got colour on there, okay? Because the more you move them around, what happens?
They break up.
They break up. That voice in the background. She's in the kitchen again. And, lady, the secret here now is to keep them nice and hot. They go really nice, almost like a roast potato.
Yeah.
This is not a difficult, finicky thing to do.
No. For me, you know, when you look at the style of Shrita's food, it's really important to keep it rustic. Don't want anything fancy. I'm not being funny, but Gavin, the kitchen porter, can get this stuff done.
Yes.
Huh?
Oh, that is good. Damn. I'm in heaven.
What I'm trying to do is make the place look less cluttered.
Yes, I understand.
Because the food speaks for itself.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes I see these mountains of food going out.
That's
okay?
Yeah.
And, you know, it's too much.
So come here. Here you go. Lick it. Go on, you know you'll want to.
What can I say? Cousin Gordon's sweet potato salad?
Yeah, yeah. That's what it's going to be called.
Go on, mix it in.
How can I mix it doing that? That was better, actually. I just
thank you, Chef.
Seriously, Chef.
No more food piled high on cold plates.
Yeah, I want to get these balls filled up.
At £10 a head, as long as it's delicious and looks good, the customers are going to love it.
So we can present it. What else is going there? Chicken? We've got jerk chicken.
Jerk chicken is... Yeah.
Brian can clear the frozen backlog and start from fresh.
Right, make it look nice. Yeah, we've got to sell this, yeah?
Yeah.
We've got to really sell it.
Simple, sexy and irresistible soul food.
Salsa as well. Come on, then do it. Yeah, do something. Fucking hell. God, damn. You're driving around the bend, you know that? Ailey, what do you think? Table of four.
Fucking good.
Huh? Fucking good.
Yeah. Hey. This is fantastic. Honestly, yes. What leftovers,
right.
What
give
you can
me
do
fucking
with it.
Yeah. Let's go.
Fucking hell.
Right, Charita.
Yeah.
Basically, we've gone through the fridge, seen what's been used up. Yes.
Yeah.
Every day is going to change.
Yes.
Here, we just made a really nice vegetable pig lily. Mm-hmm. And it just marinades through brown sugar and vinegar. And look at that there for four people.
Yeah.
You've got a mug of soup as well, don't forget. And I think it's quite sort of fresh and new.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it sort of deformalizes the restaurant because it is soul food and it's, you know, across the table.
Yeah,
but I think it also introduces everybody to a different
taste
of all the food, so everyone is having different taste of everything.
Yeah.
And the idea, of course, is once they've experienced this, they come back Friday or Saturday for a full thing.
Yeah, this looks great.
Good.
Mm-hmm. I like that.
Tomorrow we're going live.
Oh, don't worry, I'm going to be, now that you said live, you wait, I'm going to be live.
It seems Charita's well and truly sold on our new idea.
Whoa! Okay. I just gotta think of a word for tapas. I'm gonna come up with my own word. I'm gonna make a word up. But I guess I can't call it slappers, because that sounds too rude.
And short, dynamic, straight to the point.
Yep.
Yeah?
Good. The mama's on a crusade.
Right, customers.
Okay, customers. Soul and a bone, all right? And we're launching tomorrow evening, having a big party down there.
£10 each, three courses, delicious.
Oh my God.
Excellent,
okay. I'm doing ribs, jambalaya, barbecue chicken, going. Yeah.
Brownies. Yeah.
Bring some friends with you, okay?
You love the food. Yeah. Fantastic.
By tomorrow night, Charita wants the whole of West Sussex to know about Mama Sherry's.
It's a Southern FM, that's six of the best non-stop, wrapping up with the House Martins happy hour, thawing my side with me.
And its brand new midweek eating concept, Soul in a Bowl.
Go on then, Nicky, give me some of this.
The ribs are
this is ribs. Okay, here we go.
Yeah.
Gorgeous. Absolutely lovely.
You eat, I'll talk, okay? When you're hungry and you need of a serious food attack, just come to Mama Cherry's, the soul food shack. We've got soul in a bowl. Three yummy courses served on a platter, fried chicken, jambalaya, and more. We're talking soul food tapas. The price is so right, so come to the shack tonight for a memorable night.
As soon as you brought us breakfast, you can have that huge plug for nothing.
Thank you.
Delicious.
On a normal Wednesday night, Charita would be lucky to get eight customers.
Good morning, Mama Cherry's. Can I help you?
But whilst we've been out, bookings for this evening's launch have gone through the roof.
Early or late, I'm doing probably two sittings, a 7 o'clock and a 9 o'clock sitting.
It's all coming together, except for one small hitch.
There's no Brian, there's no Adi, there's no Gavin. No one's here. Brian's stuck with a fucking babysitter somewhere, God knows where. And, you know what? If they're ever going to get this place right, then they're going to have to really understand discipline, because this is a joke. Big day. No one in the fucking kitchen. Where have you been?
Looking for babysitters, Chef.
Looking for... Come on, go have a get changed, yeah?
No.
I thought you were going to be here by 10.
I was meant to be at 10, but I tried to phone a girl who looked after them yesterday.
Yeah.
She said, no, go, just like that, out of the blue.
Get changed, yeah? And let's get fucking started, yeah? Yeah. Let's go, yeah?
I was hoping the renewed responsibility of running this kitchen would relight Brian's passion for cooking.
You need, young man,
eggs.
A fucking rocket up your ass.
And with it, bring a new commitment to both raising the quality and the urgency with which the food's delivered.
How about sweating off the onions at the same time? They're in front of you there, look.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
But even if Brian was making the new improved meatloaf twice as fast,
Fucking useless.
It still wouldn't be quick enough.
I'm just testing it now to see what flavours have come out.
Yeah, but you haven't put the wet mixture in there yet, so how can you identify the texture?
Oh, yes.
Get the recipe complete first, add the breadcrumbs, then do the fucking test. Jesus Christ. Some mothers do have them. Huh? And I've got one.
Thankfully, Shrita's completely unaware that Brian's already losing it upstairs.
So how's it looking now?
It's looking full. No, what day of the week am I? Wednesday. This is wonderful.
Perfect. And 50, mm-hmm. 55 customers tonight. That's £550 on food.
Yep.
The same again.
Yep. Hopefully on the drink.
Drink. Yep. That's £1,000 in the till.
Yep.
Which is equivalent to a Friday night.
Yeah, that's a Friday night.
Show a touch of flexibility.
It's a new start for the Shack, and tonight every member of Shrita's staff has got to give 100%.
OK, here are a set of rules that each and every one of you are now going to abide by. And it's not a governing rule, it's an understanding of what this business needs to go further and forward.
I need everybody here on time. And on time means if I say you start at 6, you get here at 1:45. That way you have your cigarettes, you get changed, you chat, you have your coffee, and so that at 6 o'clock, you're on the floor, okay? The next one is there is always something to do. And if you can't think of it, ask me.
The queen is now in residence. Yes?
Exactly.
Shrita is now on the floor.
Yep, that's where I'm gonna be.
And to confirm that, we're gonna raise the flag. Yes?
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
Shrita is in residence, yes? And that's where she stays. I want you to pull this up here together. There you go. Listen, have a great service. Think customer, push the wine, and work together. Let's get it right. Right fucking now. Let's go.
Okay, inside. This is your table here.
The success of Soul in a Bowl relies on doing large numbers. At only £10 a head, Shrita must fill the restaurant twice over.
Everything prepped, yes? Are you nervous?
Yeah, I am.
Good, it's a good sign. Start shooting yourself.
Brian, Adie and Gavin have got to get those platters flying down those stairs, but they're only just peeling the last potatoes.
We're going to send you down a tray designed for two.
It comes with cornbread and soup as a starter. Soup's excellent.
So I hope you enjoy it. I think
you
will.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Thank you. Unfortunately, we are fully booked tonight, but...
It's the first Wednesday night ever they've had to turn customers away.
Slightly spicy sweet potatoes. Table 3, 2 meat tapas. Okay.
Just to bring them up to the warmth.
Table 7 that you've got up there, it's down as 3. They've had a person join them, so it's now a 4.
It's already looking better, but tonight has got to be perfect.
Stop, stop, stop. Take the fucking bowl off the tray. Put it in the bowl, yeah? I just don't want all the shit on here everywhere. Yeah, I want it nice and clean. Fucking clean. Come on. Yeah?
And for the first time this week, Brian's not smiling.
That looks lovely. Well done. Right, vegetarian, please, Eddie, send it away. So now we're looking for a 4 soup and a 3 soup. 4 cornbread, 3 cornbread. Gavin, you're taking care of the desserts. Uh-huh. Yeah?
Chicken.
The team is pulling together.
Can you put a small, just a bowl of veggie jambalaya on it? And then the big one is going to have the meat. Come on, get a pump. If we slow down, I'm going to lose it.
Communication is much, much better.
Can I get a timing on some of these so I can tell them?
5 minutes.
5 minutes? On all of them. Okay.
Keep it going, Brian.
Yep.
ADS. At 8 o'clock. So far, so good, yeah? You're doing a good job.
If they can keep it going, we might just pull this one off.
They said they are stuffed. It was delicious. All of the different flavors that go with it. Fully satisfied. I'm going to take them some dessert. You see that? Empty bowls.
And for that dessert, Adie surprised us all with his homemade pecan pies.
That is delicious. That beats panel beating any day, you know that? Any day.
At just 40 pence to make each slice, it's a fifth cheaper and 10 times tastier than the ones Shrita's been buying in.
How was the soup? Good? Yes? All right.
Things must be going okay, because we've hardly seen her in the kitchen all night.
Are we starting to turn the tables now?
I'm starting to turn, but I've got to get
this is a crucial thing
out.
At £10 a head. Yes, we have to turn those tables, yeah?
So can we do 2 trays at the same time? Is it possible?
Yeah? Now the pressure's really on.
We're losing. Come on, let's get some organisation, guys. Come on.
It's still not perfect.
A table's called away. You stick that ticket on the tray. No one touches it.
But the vibe up here has definitely got more professional.
We're losing valuable time, man. What are you doing?
Right,
2 minutes over.
How's it feeling up here?
hot, hot. Pumping.
Okay. Can't quite believe I'm saying this, but I think Bri's actually breaking a sweat.
Good guys, looking good. They're loving it. People are loving it.
Very tasty. Very good food.
You got the salads. Well done, man. Thank you.
I haven't eaten anything quite like this before, and it's really nice.
Okay, what we need is a 2, a 6, and a 4. Then we're finished.
Great. You couldn't get better value for money than this. It's remarkable.
Let's get it going. Last table goes out just like the first table, yes?
I will come back, definitely. Definitely will come back.
Nice, look at that, beautiful. Huh? Fucking well done. Yeah, really good. Yeah. That's one day. The real work starts tomorrow, yeah?
Yeah.
Let's go.
I didn't know how much I was going to cope today, you know? I didn't know if I was going to cope or break, basically, but I had just one thought in my mind is to get through this.
Thursday morning, and the whole team are in early.
You got to get that well going.
They're clean out of food stocks and fully booked tonight, so they're starting completely from scratch. Fresh home cooking straight from the soul. Hallelujah.
Can I just say, you set me a target.
Yes.
When I spoke to you last night, we hadn't reached that target.
£800 last night.
Yeah.
I asked for £1,000.
When I cashed up, I hit 1,000.
Yeah, fantastic.
Was it 1,080?
Fantastic.
Yep. And these two,
yeah,
they did it.
AD's quietly impressed me this week. But if he really wants to make it as a chef, he's got to decide where his loyalties lie.
No, I do enjoy it, but I don't like the hours. I don't want to be working those sort of hours when I'm 30, unless I'm as rich as you. And then I won't mind.
You fucker. Can I just say, when I was your age, the age of 20, there wasn't enough hours in the fucking day for me to work. So, yeah, I'd be very happy to become successful, but you've got to work for it, big boy. It doesn't just come on a plate where you've got to read the following and it'll happen.
And Brian. Well, the success of Mama Sherry's depends on his strength and his commitment more than anybody's.
You've really pissed me off this week, you know that?
Yes. I felt really bad after, especially yesterday, when I realised that I haven't been really sort of... It's like I didn't care almost.
I just thought when I first saw you in the kitchen, you were treating it like a job, no passion.
But last night, it came back and I could feel it.
You are the head chef.
Yes.
So act like the head chef.
Yes.
Take responsibility as the head chef.
Yes.
Get a grip, wake up, and fucking stop dreaming.
And I think Sherita knows what she must do.
You are the most marketable asset of this restaurant.
Yeah, well, I'm going to be selling myself now. I'm out of that kitchen.
Understand. Kitchen morning, AM, hosting the room and being present in the evening.
Yep.
You have got to continue that.
I will do. Then I've got to take some control back.
Set a fucking example.
I'm going to.
And do not be scared to get rid of baggage.
Back in December, I spent a week at Mama Sherry's failing soul food shack, and I've never spent a week quite like it.
And he cleaned his place.
No discipline.
If you turned up for work half an hour late in my kitchen, you'd be home for the day, looking for a new fucking job.
And £65,000 in debt.
Every minute you're in here, we're losing money.
Fucking hell.
I whipped the head chef into shape.
I said no smiling, no laughing. Okay. Serious.
Okay.
Yeah? You need, young man, a fucking rocket up your ass.
And the mama found her true calling.
If you don't break away from this stove, I swear to God the business is gonna close.
What's it called?
Soul food!
Thank you! Just call me mama.
Mama.
You got it.
Together, by the end of the week, we had the shack firmly back on track.
You see the empty bowls?
It's a Wednesday night, and I'm just hoping the mama will be glad to have me back.
Hello?
Oh, my God! My cousin!
You're in the dining room?
Of course. Where else would I be?
You are.
I'm out of the kitchen. And soul in the bowl.
Still going?
Going well. I mean, I wish you could have been here last night. We were absolutely full.
What, upstairs, on a Tuesday?
On a Tuesday. Upstairs and downstairs.
Amazing. Yeah. Staff-wise, how are they getting with staff?
A lot better. You see, Lauren's actually in a uniform.
Hi, Lauren. Were you late today?
No. I came in early today, actually.
Early? Oh, yes. I know.
Yeah. My moonwalker, where is he?
Oh, he's upstairs.
Is he?
Where he's supposed to be.
Yeah, can I go and see him?
yeah, go on, let's surprise him.
It's great to hear that Brian sorted out his babysitting problems. Sharita's been able to take him on full-time as Mama Cherry's head chef, and he's a changed man.
How you doing, big boy?
Fine,
you well?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good to see you.
It's nice to see you again.
On weekdays, he's running the kitchen single-handed, and he seems to be thriving on the responsibility.
That looks fantastic. You're not throwing things in there anymore now. You place them in there nicely. They actually look smart.
It's better. It looks better.
Huh?
It does, yes.
What's happened to you over the last 2 months?
I went through a phase, the state you found me in when you came in was totally sort of...
The Lord's come down and touched you.
I'd given up.
All credit to Brian. He's taken soul in a bowl and run with it. It's looking really fresh.
Now, you also get starters, and you get a choice of nachos or soup. Nachos. 5 nachos.
How long is it taking now for the food to come out? On the tray?
On the tray, it's taking about, at least, I would say about 6-7 minutes. It should
Good.
Be 5 minutes.
So quick?
Quick as possible as I can be, yeah.
So you haven't lost your touch then?
No, not really. It's coming back slowly, you know, when you lose a bit of confidence, it's kind of difficult to sort of try and find yourself back again. You know, but at the moment, I'm so into it, and I'm going to get it done, whatever happens.
Okay, here we go.
The team has been stripped down, and the customers seem to love their new improved food. It's all good for business.
Smells good. We've got some jerk chicken, your meat jambalaya, hot wings, barbecue ribs.
January's takings are up a staggering 60% on last year, despite now being closed on a Monday. And last Saturday, Sharita filled the restaurant 3 times over, with Brian and Adie cooking for a massive 105 customers.
I'd love to see you spinning around doing 105 covers, you know that?
Yeah?
I bet you were moonwalking all over the fucking shop.
Oh, I didn't see the moonwalk for a second there.
Okay, here we go. Soul in the bowl.
Thank you.
Let's see what we got here for you tonight.
Brian looks well.
Is exactly what I wanted him to get some confidence, and he's got that self-confidence.
I walk in and see what you've done to the menus.
Can you see what I've done to the
they
menus?
They look fantastic.
Can you see what I've done to the menus? And I've also created my own soul and explaining it out to
easy
people.
Format, no easy. Intimidation.
Yeah.
And, you know, when I think back to that folder and go through those pages and all that crap on that, you know,
I mean, now look. Because it was like a book, but I think it was too much to do.
It was taking up too much space.
They're smart.
What's happening now is I've got people coming on the weekdays ordering the soul in the bowl, and then they say to me, I can't wait to book a weekend because I know now I'm having those ribs. They weren't enough.
So how worried you were. Yeah. So what wasn't happening in the business, actually?
No.
That stress has gone.
The stress is gone because now I feel that there is a future. Before, I didn't think there was a future.
Yeah.
I've got that fire back inside of me.
Yeah. I've noticed that.
Yeah, and you know where the business is going.
Yeah, and I know where it's going and where it can go. Yeah.
So are you making the perfect fucking sponge cake? do you remember that one?
Yes, I know.
You do?
I will never forget that one.
So if you had to put it together now, where would it come out, your cake?
My cake will come out better than your cake.
That means you're cooking the books.
Long live Mama Cherry and her finger-licking food. I'll definitely be back for more.
Great, great, great. I bet you can't make it past 20 metres.
20 metres?
You're full of shit, you know that.
OK.
Go for it. Tired?
No, not yet. Not yet.
But you look tired.
You fucking wimp. Still going.
I know. Give us a spin. Give us a spin.
Spin, spin, spin.
Fuck off. Fucking hell, it doesn't cost anything in Scotland.
Be soft, out of my way.
I'm just worried that you don't fall into the same fucking trap that I did.
We are ready.
It's gone! What a load of bollocks.
Big Soul Mama Sharita is going online right now for a chat. Hit channel4.com/Ramsey to take part. Next tonight, Maxwell will not go unpunished. Big Brother.